A group previously backing the presidential bid of Manila Mayor Francisco Isko Moreno Dumagoso has shifted alliance and is now on the side of his rival, Vice President Lenny Robredo. The Visayas chapter of Ikaw Muna Pilipinas explains. Recent pre-election survey results show the presidential race may be down to just two candidates, Robredo and frontrunner Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. The group adds that their main concern now is to prevent the late Philippine dictator's son from becoming president. As for the national conveners of Ikaw Muna Pilipinas, they said they have yet to decide whether to adopt the move of their counterpart in the Visayas as they are still monitoring developments there.
A group of some 12,000 doctors also show their collective support for Vice President Lenny Robredo and running mate Senator Kiko Pangilinan. Doctors for Lenny and Kiko says Robredo and Pangilinan are the only candidates who have a clear anti-COVID platform.
Saksi kami sa mga masamang epekto ng maling pamamahala ngayong pandemya na nagdudulot ng matinding kahirapan at pagkamatay ng ating mga health workers at kapwa Pilipino. Naniniwala kami na ngayon ang panahon na maging makatotohanan at manindigan upang pahalagahan ang buhay.
Doctors have made it their mission to encourage more voters to support the Robredo-Pangilinan tandem. They said they've been sharing stories with their staff and patients about Robredo's efforts to assist the healthcare sector during the pandemic.
Philippine President Duterte rules out supporting any candidate in the race to succeed him. But in a speech in Batangas Monday, Duterte says he supports his daughter, Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte, in her bid for the vice presidency.
Ako wala na, tapos na ako. I am not supporting any candidate, except of course, my daughter. Ako, boboto talaga ako sa anak ko.
The president's comments solidify his refusal to endorse his daughter's running mate, Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. Duterte's party PDP Laban is backing the presidential bid of the son and namesake of the late dictator, Ferdinand Marcos Sr.
President Duterte is still pushing for charter change, which was one of his unfulfilled campaign promises. This time, the chief executive says the constitution should be changed so that the partyless system will not be abused by rich and political clans.
Ako wala na, tapos na ako. I am not supporting any candidate, except of course, my daughter. Ako, boboto talaga ako sa anak ko.
Experts have already urged Congress to review the 1995 partyless system law to fix its flaws. Election watchdog Contradaya said in March that 120 out of 177 partyless groups were identified with political clans and big businesses. A 2013 Supreme Court ruling made it possible for non-members of marginalized sectors to represent organizations allowed to run as partyless groups, leading to the system's current state.
A Philippine election official is pushing for the creation of a task force to combat poll-related disinformation. COMELEC Commissioner George Garcia says the task force would only act on disinformation about the poll body and the electoral process.
Yung mga ganyan pong fake news, siyempre po, sa mga kababayan natin na maaari hindi ganun naunawaan, ay mapaniniwalaan po yan. It will create or destroy the integrity of our electoral process. We will never allow that. Yung pong fake news para sa mga kandidato na po, napakadami po na, baka hindi namin kayaanin na po yun. Dapat talaga isang buong departamento ng pamahalaan niya.
The COMELEC also eyeing tougher sanctions for candidates who skip debates. COMELEC Commissioner George Garcia says the agency will push for the creation of a law that could disqualify local and national candidates from the polls if they refuse to join the events. Garcia adds the poll body wants to make debates mandatory, especially in the next elections.
Kukumbinsihin po natin ang ating kagalang-galang na Kongreso na sana po ilagay na po talaga sa na requirement na a-attend ang lahat ng mga magiging kandidato, local man at national, sa mga ipapatawag na debate ng Commission on Election. Kung hindi, pwede siya maging ground ng disqualification. At the same time, pwede maging ground ng election offense.
Here's our brief on the campaign trail Monday. Senators Panfilo Lacson and Vicente Soto III take their campaign to Romblon. Lacson confirms Senator Mick Zubiri has been removed from his senatorial slate after the lawmaker raised the hand of former Senator Bongbong Marcos during a campaign sortie on Saturday. Back in February, senatorial bets Sherwin Gachalian and Herbert Bautista were also dropped from Lacson's lineup after openly campaigning for Marcos. Some 12,000 doctors who call their group Doctors for Lenny and Kiko endorse the tandem of Vice President Lenny Robredo and Senator Kiko Pangilinan. Also on Monday, Robredo's eldest daughter, Aika, led a house-to-house campaign in Bulacan, while Pangilinan held a virtual town hall meeting with Filipino workers in Malaysia. And Labor leader Lodi de Guzman joins an online environmental forum. De Guzman said rich countries, which contributed to the most to global carbon emission, should compensate third world nations like the Philippines, which are bearing the brunt of the effects of climate change.
The Interior Department warns officials running in the May polls against using government resources in their campaigns. Vivian Gulia reports.
Using government resources and personnel for campaigning is prohibited. The DILG reiterated this in warnings, advisories, and memos issued to local government units, according to Interior Secretary Eduardo Anyo. He issued this statement as reports of alleged violations surfaced on social media.
Kinukuha natin yung atensyon ng mga NGOs na nare-report sa social media. Ang tagad-tagad naman nagre-react. At may mga pinadala na rin tayo ng show cause orders sa mga talagang blatant yung pagiging gawa ng violation sa election campaign.
Anyo says the DILG will handle the administrative offenses and refer violations of the Omnibus Election Code to the Commission on Elections. The Interior Department also urges the COMELEC to soon issue a resolution reactivating the Task Force Against Vote Buying, dubbed Task Force Contra Bigay. The agency's spokesman says they plan to form local task forces under it in every city and municipality, which will immediately act on tips of cash distribution in exchange of votes. COMELEC expects to issue the resolution within the week.
Hindi po natin siguro matatanggal ang vote buying sa buong Pilipinas. No? Kasi hanggat may mga taong nagbebenta ng kanilang boto, hindi natin mapipigilan. Ngunit, kung mababawasan po natin kahit 20% lamang, 30% lamang, 50% lamang mabawas natin sa vote buying, napakalaking tulong na po yan sa ating demokrasya.
The DILG warns law enforcers and barangay officials that they may face charges if found engaging in partisan political activity. The agency notes it reassigned to other areas PNP personnel who have relatives running for public office in their area of assignment.
Ang kaparusahan po, pwede po silang makasuhan sa COMELEC as an election offense at tinitingnan namin ang tinatawag nating administrative offense dahil kasama po dito ang Civil Service Commission na nag-issue at ipafilan po natin ito sa Office of the Ombudsman.
The DILG tells LGUs they only have until Thursday to form their own local governance transition teams to ensure the smooth turnover of government operations when a new administration takes over after June 30th. The COMELEC assures the public it is ready to push through with the elections in case the Philippines sees a surge in COVID cases next month. Jimenez says the poll body has been training alternate Board of Election inspectors and is also preparing isolated polling places for voters who appear to have COVID symptoms.
On the outside chance na sa isang lugar, lahat ng BEI nagkasakit at lahat ng alternates nagkasakit, maaring ma-delay yung elections pero hanggang sa makakuha ka lang ng bagong BEI. And that's probably going to take a day or two lamang. Yung sinasabi nilang mga no-L scenarios, hindi mangyayari yun. Yun, zero chance.
Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.